For number 58, we're going to solve the word problem, and here we have two formulas that we're going to use. So if Emery has $1,300 to invest at 9% per year compounded monthly, how long will it be before he has $2,600? And if the compounding is continuous, how long will it be? And remember to round your answers to 3 decimal places. So we're going to use these formulas in order to find our answer. We're essentially finding how long it'll take if it's compounded monthly versus if it's compounded continuously. So let's go ahead and see what we have from the word problem. So Emery has $1,300 to start off with. So since we're starting off with $1,300, $1,300 is our principal amount. Okay, now he is investing 9% per year. So we're going to use 9% as our rate. But we need to put it in decimal form. In order to do that, we're going to take our percentage and divide it by 100, which is going to give us 0.09. Furthermore, we're trying to see how long it'll be before Emery has $2,600. So our ending amount is $2,600. Now, it all just depends on whether we are compounding monthly and compounding continuously. Okay, so the first part of the problem versus the second part of the problem. If we are compounding monthly, or if we are compounding at another specific number, like weekly or daily or semi-annually or something like that, then we are going to use the first formula. Because the first formula is based off of compounding some number of times during a year. In this case, it's going to be monthly. So there are 12 months in a year, so it's going to be compounded 12 times in a year. So our n is going to be 12. So let's plug in what we have into our formula. Our ending amount is 2,600. Our principal amount is 1,300. Our rate is 0.09. And we are compounding monthly, so 12 times in a year. Now let's solve for t. So let's divide both sides by 1,300. Now on the right-hand side, we have a base raised to the power of an exponent, and we need to get the t out of the exponent area. So in order to do that, we're going to take the ln of both sides, and that's going to give us the ln of 2 is equal to the ln of 1 plus 0.09 over 12 to the power of 12t. Now that we have logarithmic expressions, we can follow a logarithmic rule that states that if you have an exponent, you can bring it out to the front of the expression as a coefficient. So that's exactly what we're going to do. Now, since we're trying to get t by itself, we're going to divide both sides by everything that's not t, so the 12 and then the ln of the 1 plus 0.09 over 12. And that's going to give us t is equal to the ln of 2 over 12 times the ln of 1 plus 0.09 over 12. Now from here, you would just need to plug this into your calculator, and it's very important that you plug it in correctly. Make sure that the parentheses are where they're supposed to be, and the division side is actually dividing the numerator that you want over the denominator that you want. Plugging that into my calculator, I got t is equal to 7.730, and the next number is 4, but we are rounding only 3 decimal places, so I'm leaving the 0 as is, and we don't even really need to write that 0 because it is a decimal. So the answer is going to be t equals 7.73 years. What about if it's compounded continuously? Well, if it is compounded continuously, we are going to use the second formula. We're going to use the A equals P times E to the power of RT. So let's go ahead and plug in what we have into this formula. Our A is 2,600. Our P is 1,300. The e here is a constant. It is not a variable, so it's an actual number. It stands for something, so we're not going to plug that in for anything because it's not a variable. And then our r is 0.09. So let's try to get t by itself, first and foremost by dividing each side by 1300, giving us 2 is equal to e to the power of 0.09t. And we're going to take the ln of both sides, and that's going to give us the ln of 2 is equal to the ln of e to the power of 0.09t. Now, because we have logarithmic expressions, we can use the logarithmic rule that states that the exponent can be put out in front as a coefficient instead. So that's going to give us the ln of 2 is equal to 0.09t times the ln of e. Now, the ln of e is just 1, so that's going to be 1 times 0.09t. So now we're going to divide each side by 0.09, and that's going to give us that t is equal to the ln of 2 over 0.09. And by plugging that into the calculator carefully, that's going to give us t is equal to 7.70. The next numbers are 1 and then 6, and then we're rounding 3 decimal places, so that's gonna turn the 1 into a 2. So our answer is going to be t equals 7.702 years. So when we are compounding monthly, it'll take Emery 7.73 years. And when we are compounding continuously, it'll take Emery about 7.702 years.